Welcome to the E-Academy. This episode will focus on temperature measurement using ABAX 2 wireless system devices. I'll show you how to display temperature values on the INT TSG touchscreen keypad, working with the Integra series control panel. I'll also demonstrate how to view temperature readouts on any other keypad connected to a control panel of this series. Finally, I'll check how to display temperature indications in the Integra Control mobile application. When talking to installers, in many cases we come across the belief that with ABAX 2, only two devices can be used to measure temperature. AXD200, which is a universal detector that can operate as a temperature detector, and ADD200, which is an outdoor dusk and temperature detector. However, the truth is somewhat different. While in fact, only these two detectors can report violations when set temperature thresholds are exceeded, other ABAX 2 system devices also have built-in temperature sensor. Here is a list of them. APD200 and APD200 PET PIR motion detectors, APMD250 dual tech motion detector, AOD210 outdoor dual tech motion detector, AOCD260 outdoor dual tech curtain detector, AGD200 glass break detector, ASD200 smoke and heat detector, and ASP215 indoor wireless acoustic optical siren. It should be noted here that if a selected device is available in several color versions, the temperature measurement function is always available, regardless of the color of the housing. Okay, let's go on to the practical part. In today's episode, I'm going to use a kit consisting of Integra 128 Plus Control Panel, ACU 220 System Controller, and the INT TSG Touchscreen Keypad. For temperature measurements, I'll use the ABAX 2 wireless devices. AXD200, APMD250, and ADD200 detectors, and the ASP215 acoustic optical siren. This system is also fitted with the INT GSM module. It is required for presenting temperature readouts in the Integra control application. The INT TSG touchscreen keypad, ACU 220 system controller, and INT GSM module are already identified in the system. It's worth reminding that details of setting up the ACU 220 system controller for operation and specifically setting of DIP switches were discussed in episode 58. And when it comes to addressing devices in the alarm system, we talked more about it in episode 33. Okay, the control panel has the service mode active and is connected to a computer. Now I'm going on to the Deload X program. To add the first device to the ACU 220 controller, I open the Structure window. I go to the Hardware tab and open the Expansion Modules Bus 1 menu. I go to the AC module. I click Read button. We can see that the device list under the Zones Outputs tab is completely empty. At first, I'll add the AXD200 detector, which has been configured as a reorientation sensor. At this point, I'd like to remind you that the way the AXD200 detector mode is selected was also discussed in episode 58. To add a detector, I click New Device. I enter the detector's serial number and insert a battery. As I mentioned before, the detector has reported as ARD200, which is a reorientation detector. I click OK to approve the entries. Before I check if the temperature measured by the newly added device is available in the system, I need to perform expander identification. Please note that the detector has been added at zone number 17. This information will be needed in a moment. On the side, we can see a field labeled temperature correction. Here you can set a correction within a range of plus or minus 3.5 degrees. This means that if you set a correction of plus 2 degrees here, 2 degrees will be added to the temperature recorded by the sensor. As a result, the displayed temperature will be 23 degrees instead of the measured 21 degrees. Additionally, in the Zones window, I set a wiring of any type. For the purpose of this presentation, I'll select zone type 47, no alarm action. I save the data in the control panel. I go back to the Structure window. To display a temperature value on the INT TSG screen, I go to the Keypads tab. Here I select INT TSG and the Screen Status tab. I read data from the keypad. At the moment, the status screen is empty. From the optional items list, I select Temperature. I click Add. We can see that a box has appeared on the status screen, which will eventually display temperature values. I'll now select the number of the zone to which the detector is assigned. My AXD200 detector has been registered at position 17. We can see immediately that the name of the edited field on the list has changed. Owing to this, it is clear which zone the added field of the temperature type refers to. I also changed the font size to make it easy to identify on the keypad touchscreen what the just added indication refers to. I'll add a text field with the detector name. I arrange the boxes on the screen. I click Write. So, I'm going to the keypad now. As you can see, the status screen is already showing temperature measured by the sensor installed in the universal detector added to the system. Now let's go to the motion detector. I'm going back to the ACU controller. The whole procedure of adding a detector will be similar to the one I've just presented. I add the APMD250 detector to the system. Identification. The detector has been added at position 18. I select a wiring type and zone type. I send the data to the control panel. Now I go to settings of the keypad status screen. I add a temperature field and select zone 18. And now a text field with the detector name. I arrange the text boxes on the screen. I save the data in the keypad. After a while, we can see that the readout from the temperature sensor of the APMD250 detector is also displayed on the screen. Similarly to what I've just done, I will add the ADD200 outdoor dusk and temperature detector to the system. Identification. Approval. The detector took two zones in the system, namely the 19th and 20th. It's worth noting here that in this case, information about temperature will be transmitted from both zones. Right away, I'll add the ASP215 siren to the system. Identification. Approval. The ASP215 indoor acoustic optical siren takes two outputs and two zones in the system. In the case of temperature, we are interested in zones numbers. These are 21 and 22. For zones 19 to 22, I set wiring and zone types. I send the data to the control panel. Okay, I'm going to settings of the INT-TSG keypad status screen. For test purposes, I'll place on the screen readouts from both zones used by the ADD200 detector. So I add a temperature field and select zone 19. Then I do the same thing with zone 20. I place the detector name. Finally, I'll add a temperature readout from the sensor installed in the siren. So I select temperature and zone 21. I add a description. I save the data in the keypad. Okay, just after a while, we can see that the status screen is showing temperature readouts from the detectors and siren. To get different readouts, each of the devices has been placed in a different room. On the other hand, the ADD200 detector is placed outside the building. Let's check the display after a few minutes. This is an example view of the status screen, which displays current temperatures measured with the ABAX 2 system devices installed in different parts of a given facility. In a similar way, you can set up the temperature readout display on the touchscreen keypad and touch keypad. So far, so good. However, how could I view temperatures read from ABAX 2 devices using any keypad of the Integra system? Have a look. In this episode, we're using the INT-TSG device. In the first place, I have to enter the terminal, which is an equivalent of a standard keypad. I enter a user password on the keyboard and confirm it with an asterisk. An important thing is that option 21, access to menu test, must be enabled in a given user's authority levels. I go to the test function. I find temperatures. I can use the arrows to scroll through the readouts. You should remember that only temperatures from zones assigned to partitions to which the user has access will be displayed. It is also important that a given keypad may only display temperature readouts from zones assigned to partitions supported by this keypad. Finally, I'll show you how temperature indications look like in the Integra Control application. I open the application. Enter a user password. And go to the Temperatures tab. Current temperature indications from individual devices can be seen here. It may happen that temperatures are not displayed in this tab. What are possible reasons for this? Firstly, zones to which devices fitted with temperature sensors are assigned must have a wiring type selected. You mustn't leave the no detector setting. Secondly, as I mentioned a moment ago, a system user logged into the application has access only to temperatures from those zones that are in the partitions to which they have access. That's all for this episode. Remember that after logging in on support the website, you will find, among other things, all eAcademy episodes and archival recordings of our webinars. You can also follow the SATEL channel on YouTube. Thank you, and remember to watch the next eAcademy episode. See you next time.